Hello, educators. Welcome back to Conscious Teaching's Top 10 Tips, Tricks, and Strategies for a Great Start to Your New School Year. I'm Katie Anderson, and today we're going to be talking about consistency. Consistency is going to be vital for success in whichever area or areas you said that you wanted to focus on in your upcoming school year. We're going to talk about two different types of consistency today, procedural consistency and behavioral consistency. With procedural consistency, what we simply mean is making sure that you are following through on holding your students accountable for the classroom procedures you put into place. I'm going to use hand raising as an example because almost all teachers at one point do ask their students to raise their hands, but it's a procedure that can quickly go off the rails if it's not enforced and if students aren't held accountable for it. For example, we'll have students that will just shout out the answer, even if it's a correct answer, instead of raising their hands. And that puts us in a bit of a moral dilemma. Do we honor the content? The student got the answer right. Or do we honor the procedure? They did not raise their hand. So in those moments, keep this phrase in mind. Procedure precedes content. We want to make sure that we're honoring the procedure over the content, because if we don't, our procedures are going to fall apart. The students will quickly see that not only do they not have to follow the procedure, but that whichever students are not following the procedure are getting the attention from the teacher. Now, a quick word about procedural consistency. It doesn't always make sense for us to ask for the same procedure all day, every day, so it's fine if you don't always want your students to raise your hand. Procedural consistency does, however, mean getting what we want when we want it, and one of the best ways to do that is to make it clear to the students when you do or do not expect hand raising. Say you're doing a class brainstorm and you just want students to call things out. You can say, during this brainstorm, we don't have to raise hands, we're just going to call things out. And after the brainstorm, and we're back to hand raising. Just make it clear for students what you want and they will rise to the occasion. With behavioral consistency, it simply means do what you say you're going to do when it's attached to student behavior. And that's whether you're going to give them a reward or whether you are going to give them a consequence. This helps us build trust with our students when they know they can trust us to do what we say we're going to do. All students, no matter what their age, their background, or their ability level, crave safety and structure from us. And so by following through with behavioral consistency, we can give them that. It also gives us the added benefit as educators of taking a step back and making sure that we are not saying things out of desperation to see a certain behavior. You can have the rest of the day for free time if you're just good for the next 5 minutes, and that we're not letting our frustration overtake. You're going to have detention for the rest of the school year. We want to make sure that we're not saying things that we can't follow through on, and keeping our mindset on behavioral consistency will help us do that. So looking back at the list you made last time, what are some opportunities that you see for consistency within those one or two areas that you chose to focus on? Keep thinking about that, and we'll see you soon for our next video. Thanks for watching.